The Last of Us Part 2 is due out for release in late May, almost early June. It comes out towards the end of the month, I believe, on the 29th. I'm very much excited for the game. As I mentioned in another recent video that I uploaded, this game is currently my second most anticipated game of 2020, and there's a lot of expectations that are riding on this game. A lot of people are expecting big things from this game, and there's no doubt that Naughty Dog is going to deliver a great product. But this video isn't about the game itself. This video is about the collector's editions that were announced for this game quite some time ago. I will be getting one of these collector's editions of The Last of Us Part 2. But before I divulge my opinion as to what I personally think about the collector's editions, I'm going to briefly go over what the three separate editions are, over the standard edition of the game, and then I'm going to talk about which one I'm getting and why. So the first edition I'm going to talk about is the special edition. This is $20 more than the standard edition of the game, and it comes with a 48-page mini art book from Dark Horse, a steelbook case, which includes the game itself, an exclusive PS4 dynamic theme, and a set of 6 PSN avatars. So you get some digital content, and then you get the art book and the steelbook case. For most people, that's enough. Then you have the more expensive collector's edition of the game, which is $170. This includes the art book, the steelbook, the dynamic theme, and the PSN avatars, the same as the special edition version of the game. But it also includes a lithograph art print, a thank you letter, a replica of Ellie's bracelet in the game, 6 enamel pins, a set of 5 stickers, and the Ellie statue, which is 12 inches in height. And finally, you have the Super Ultra Mega Edition of The Last of Us Part 2, which is called the Ellie Edition, and this retails for $230. And it includes everything from the previous editions of the game, but it also adds The Last of Us Part 2 logo patch, a 7-inch vinyl record featuring music from the original soundtrack of the game, and a replica of Ellie's backpack. So those are all the separate editions, aside from the standard edition of this game that you can purchase. And I know recently they made more copies of the Ellie edition, but obviously copies are limited. Same thing with the collector's edition of the game. And so now I'm going to go into what edition of this game that I'm personally going to get, and that is the collector's edition. Now, there's 4 main reasons why I'm getting this collector's edition. The first is that it's not too expensive, and typically I can't stand collector's editions for video games because quite often they are overpriced and filled with a bunch of nonsense that I'm not going to use or need. And so this is pretty much an exception, the only exception I'll probably ever make. The second reason is Naughty Dog has a great track record. They consistently release good games that are of high quality and are often respected in the industry. And the first, The Last of Us, was my favorite game that came out last decade, so odds are if the first game was good, then the second game is going to be just as good, if not better. That's usually how it goes for video games anyway. The third reason that I'm getting this, and the most primary reason why I'm getting it, is because of the Ellie statue. Now, the Ellie statue isn't something that I really want, but it's something I'm curious about as far as the quality of it, because I've never actually bought one of these collector's editions that is this expensive when it comes to the price. And usually these things are priced the way they are because they come with some sort of statue. So I'm curious as to what the quality of this statue is going to be. And I will be doing an unboxing of the collector's edition for this game. And that statue, I'm definitely going to have some things to say about that statue that comes in this edition for this game. And the fourth reason why I decided to get the collector's edition for The Last of Us Part 2 is because I actually found a good deal on it. Right now, I'm only paying $17 a month, these monthly payments through Affirm, for this particular edition of this game. And if I end up not liking the product, I can just pack it up and send it back and just get the standard edition of the game, if need be. And so that's the edition that I'm getting. And as far as I'm concerned, the collector's edition for The Last of Us Part 2 is the best edition of the game. if you want all the extra shit that comes with it, but I want to comment real briefly on the Ellie edition. This edition right here, this kind of shit right here is the reason why I hate collector's editions for video games. First of all, this is overpriced at $230. Anyone who spends that kind of money on a video game isn't very smart. No, there's something wrong with you if you spend that kind of money on a video game. And then, the extra items that come in the Ellie edition really is useless. Like, what would you do with the logo patch? I mean, what's the point of owning something like that? The 7-inch vinyl record. You gotta have a vinyl record player in order to use that. And it's not like you can just walk into any retail store and buy something like that. They really don't make vinyl records like that anymore. So I'm not really sure why anyone would want something like that. And then you have the backpack. And that is about the dumbest thing that I've seen for any collector's edition I've ever taken a look at. It's a backpack. It's a fucking backpack. What, like, I get it. Like, the whole point is it's supposed to be a replica of the backpack that the character uses in the game, but that's stupid. That's dumb. It's a fucking backpack. And it doesn't even look like a good backpack. Like, I bet you could go to your local retail store, like a major retailer like Target, Best Buy, Walmart, or even Staples or somewhere like that, and pick up a backpack that's of much higher quality than whatever the hell this thing is supposed to be. And like I said, for $230, it's just not worth it. But of course, gamers being the way they are and loving to spend money without thinking first, this edition of the game has already sold out. So if you want it, well, too bad, because it doesn't seem like they're going to make any more of these. After the second wave of copies are made for the Ellie edition, it's highly unlikely that you'll be able to get this, unless you get it off of eBay or something like that. That's what I got to say about the collector's editions for The Last of Us Part 2. If anything, I would say the special edition is the safest bet if you want something more than just the standard game. The collector's edition is the highest anyone should go for this, and the Ellie edition is just complete bullshit. Now again, The Last of Us Part 2 comes out in late May, and I will be doing an unboxing of the collector's edition, and I will be doing a retrospective of the game after I finish it, of course. And I'm expecting big things from this game, and I hope it's a worthwhile sequel to what's considered to be one of the absolute best video games that has come out over the past 10 years.
You don't know how large that group is? How armed?
I don't care.